The days are long gone when the churches could be left unprotected in the knowledge that their reputation as places of prayer would deter thieves and vandals. In the Merseyside area, there have been many burglaries and acts of vandalism on churches and church buildings.
In about February of this year, we closed up Sunday evening after our evening service, and the first we knew about it was the following morning when the verger came and said that the door was open and people had been into church. When we came in, we found that the electrical equipment had been stolen, the PA system. But far worse than that was the mess that had been left behind. Cupboards had been rifled through, vestment cupboards had been opened, and the contents scattered around the vestry, and wax from various lighted candles had been poured all over the place.
Many churches in the Merseyside area were ignoring the threat of crime. So in 1995, the Church Watch Scheme was launched. The scheme brought together good security advice with community monitoring. If the church alarm bells rang, then the community would respond. But does it work?
I'm Hilary Lynn Forth and I live opposite St Luke's Church. On Sunday evening, while watching telly, I heard the alarms go off. So I came outside to check that it was the church alarms. Then I went inside to phone Diane, the church warden.
I'm Diane Regan, church warden of St Luke the Evangelist, Walton. And on Sunday night around 9 o'clock, I received a phone call to say the alarms were going in the church. So I come around to check what was going on. It was a neighbour who had contacted us. And we came in and we found, because we'd had the windows open on Sunday, because of the heat, a swarm of flies had got in and they'd triggered off the infrared. We have written to neighbours telling them what's going on, telling them about the church watch. And so they are aware that if they do hear the alarms, there are numbers they've got to contact. And we've put notices up outside to let people know that this is a church watch area. And I think, you know, living in an area like this, surrounded by houses, I think that helps us a great deal.
I'm Harry Ross, I'm the Vicar of St Luke the Evangelist, in the corner of Everton's football ground in Walton. And a lot of the problems that we've had here at St Luke's have been in the past because a lot of fans going to watch Everton Football Club would use my church roof as a good vantage point. We've had a person or persons trying to get into the church through one of the clear story windows, and when he couldn't get access, he decided to kick in one of my other windows, the St Luke window, and did quite about £2,000 worth of damage. So we brought in the crime prevention officer, who has been in before, but he came in and gave us more specific advice on what we needed to do. We've also put in passive infrared rays on all the high points in the church as well as all the lower access points, and that means that the alarms are triggered. We decided to have bell sounders put at the front of the church and also in Gladys Street at the side of the church on the church hall. So it means now that with the local people, with Church Watch, they will hear the alarm and immediately ring either the church wardens, myself or other key holders, or the police, and inform them right away, and that's worked extremely well.
I suppose our security measures are very few. We've only got one door that opens from the outside, but they gained access through a window which was forced. Some time ago we considered installing an alarm system, but I think people were concerned at the time that that would suggest that we got valuables inside.
My name is Mavis Spurgeon. I'm the PCC Secretary and our Treasurer for St Luke Walton. We have managed as a PCC to implement quite a lot of security devices within our budget. Through this, we have been able to have our annual insurance premiums reduced by about £400.
I think the biggest incentive would be preventing what happened in February happening again. If that also had a knock-on effect, that the insurer would give us perhaps a more favourable deal with our fairly expensive insurance cover at the moment, then that would obviously be a great incentive as well.